Hey there and welcome to my latest video. My name's Anita and I'm going to show you today how to live stream using StreamYard to your Instagram account. Yep, you heard me right. So normally on Instagram, you can only live stream via your mobile phone. But in December 2023, Instagram opened up the what's known as the API, in other words, the gateway to the Instagram live streaming options. And they opened it up to any multi-streaming app that we have out on the marketplace. Now, I use StreamYard, but there are other apps out there that you can use, such as Restream, Ecamm, Wave.video. I'm going to show you in this video how to actually use StreamYard to live stream into Instagram. So as you can see from the screen, here is StreamYard. So if you haven't already got an account, grab the link from below this video and you can sign up. Now, when you do sign up, you do need to log in. So when you click log in, it's going to ask you for your email address. Go ahead and add your email address and click the login code. Now, StreamYard has a failsafe, so you do have to check your email. So I just wanted to show you that, because if you are new to StreamYard and you're not sure where to find this 6-digit code, you do need to go into your email to look for it. Just copy it from your email and then come here and click paste and it will fill that in for you. Now, when you first log in, you'll land on the homepage, which is where your streams and recordings will be found. What we want to do first is go to the destination tab and add on your Instagram account. As you can see from mine, I have my Facebook, my LinkedIn and my YouTube connected, but I don't have my Instagram. Now, just so that you know, when we add the Instagram account to StreamYard, you will need to log into your Instagram account through StreamYard using your username and your password. So let's go and see how this happens. Okay, so let's click on add a destination. Now, as you can see here, we've got this option to go to Instagram Live now. So go ahead and click the Instagram Live button. Now it's going to ask you for your Instagram username. So go ahead and put the exact username in and click add Instagram Live. Oh, my Instagram account was connected. So I didn't actually need my password, but that may be because I'm already logged in to my Instagram account on my browser. So if you do see the need to put a password in, then make sure you add it. Otherwise, do what I did. Log into your Instagram account on your browser before you do this, and then you don't need to actually put your password in. So just to check that it's in there, click the destination option, and as you can see, Instagram has now been connected. Okay, so that's the first part of how to go live on Instagram using StreamYard. Okay, so now that we've connected the destinations, we need to make sure that we've done two things on our Instagram app. The first one is that your account is not a personal account, that it is a professional account. So if you see the professional dashboard on the front, like you can see on my screen now, then you already are using a professional account. If you don't see that, then if you go up to the top right hand corner where there's three little lines are and go to settings and privacy and scroll down where it says for professionals, click that. And down the bottom, you can see switch account type. So if you're on a personal account, you will get the option to switch to either a business account or a creator account. You do need to be on a creator account or a business account in order for you to live stream using StreamYard into Instagram. So once you've done that, the only other thing you need to do is come back to the hamburger area again and go to settings and privacy again and scroll down until you get to the archiving and downloading option. Click on that and make sure that you have the save live to archive switched on. What that will do is that at the end of your live stream on Instagram, you will have the option to close the window down. And when you close the window down, your live stream will be saved into Instagram for you in the archive, and then it's up to you whether you want to pull that live stream onto your profile grid or not inside the Reels tab. Okay, so once you've done that, that's the Instagrammy things done on your phone. You do have something else to do on Instagram from your desktop. So we're going to create the live stream now. So in order to do that, we click create and we go to live stream. Now, we need to choose where we want to live stream. So we already know we want to go to Instagram. We've already done the changes on our app. So we click on the Instagram icon and we give our live stream a title. So now what I recommend you do is you copy this title, because we have to put this title into Instagram as well. And we also have to go to our Instagram account and get the Instagram stream key. So we're going to open up Instagram in a new tab. So once you're in your Instagram, you do need to mute this tab, because when we are live streaming from our StreamYard, we don't want to hear the audio coming out of our Instagram account. And we have to keep this page open whilst we're live streaming. I know that sounds a bit complicated, but it really is easy. All you need to do is go to the tab in question, right click it, and it will give you an option to mute the site. Just go ahead and do that, and then you won't get any audio from your Instagram account whilst you're doing the live stream. Now we need to go to the create option, and you can see we have this live video option. Go ahead and click that, and it's going to ask us if we want to create the live stream. So we copied the title earlier, and we're going to click on there and just paste the title into that area. It's then going to ask us for the audience. So we're going to go public, and we're going to click next. Now what that's done is it's connected our StreamYard to our Instagram by giving us two sets of code. Now we only need to have the stream key code. So we're going to copy that, and we're going to go back over to our StreamYard, and we're going to place that code where it says Instagram stream key. Paste it in there and click create live stream. Now when you click create live stream, you are not going to go live, so don't panic yet. Just click create live stream, and what it's going to do is it's going to take you into the StreamYard studio. When you're in here, you just need to make sure that your camera is set up and your audio is set up. So to do that, go to the settings and select the camera that you want to use, and then go to audio and select the audio that you want to use. Now I've just left it on default. I normally use my Rode pod mic, but I'm using that to record this video for you, so I'm going to leave it as it is. If you want a virtual background, you can click virtual background as well. Once you're happy, just close it down, add your display name, that's the name that's going to show on the video, and if you want to add a headline, you can do that as well. When you enter the studio, you're still not going to be live, so don't panic. Just enter the studio, and this is where it's going to take you into the studio in order for you to set yourself up. Now in StreamYard, you do have to add yourself to the studio. So down the bottom here, you can see add to stage. Go ahead and click that, and that brings you onto the stage. Okay, we're nearly there. Now what we have to do is, in order for us to make sure that that connection has been made between StreamYard and Instagram, we need to click the Go Live key in your StreamYard studio by clicking Go Live. And then we're going to go over to our Instagram account, and we're going to wait here to see the preview. So once that connection has been made between StreamYard and Instagram, we'll see a preview here. There it is. There's the connection. So remember, I asked you to mute the tab which your Instagram is going to be on. Now that's so that we don't get you speaking to yourself. So it's like because you're live streaming from StreamYard into Instagram, and we have to have both these tabs open in order for this to work, we need to make sure that we mute our Instagram tab. It doesn't mean that the people who are on Instagram can't hear us. That's not going to happen at all. Now that we know that our StreamYard and our Instagram are connected, we can go ahead and click Go Live, and then you can just do the live stream how you would normally do it. So go ahead and click Go Live, and you will be live on your Instagram account. Okay, so once you're live on Instagram, you can go back to your StreamYard studio, and you can talk using your StreamYard studio if you want, and of course you can add on a screen share if you want to. You can add a guest on if you've brought a guest into your studio. You can do all of those things inside of your StreamYard studio, and it will show up inside of your live stream. So for example, if I put my banner on and I show that, that's going to show up inside of my live stream. Now, there is a little bit of a delay, not long, but a little bit of a delay once you've activated those things, but they will show up. As you can see there, there's the ticker. So whatever you do in your StreamYard studio, it will show up inside of your Instagram account. Now, one thing I've noticed at the moment is that I didn't see any comments coming through from Instagram. As you can see, it says can't post comments on Instagram. So the best thing to do is once you've set up your StreamYard studio and you're happy with how things are looking in here, is to keep the Instagram tab open where you're live, because you can actually comment on here and it will go through. So that's all you need to do in Instagram. So remember, your cockpit is inside of your StreamYard studio and you control what's happening in your live here on the Instagram app. Okay, and then when you click end live video, and you'll end your live stream, and that's going to stop the stream. And if I come up to my StreamYard studio, it will connect here as well and tell StreamYard that I've lost the connection. If it doesn't, then all you need to do is come up here and click end stream, and you will end your stream on Instagram. So you can do your feedback in StreamYard as well by clicking that end one here. Now, I've finished my stream in StreamYard. So let's just jump back to Instagram. It says here, to download your video, view this in your archive on your Instagram app. Now, remember when I was on Instagram earlier, I told you to go into your settings and turn on the live archive. So if I go here, to download your video, view this in your archive on the Instagram app. So I'm going to close this off by clicking the cross and I'm going to click discard. But it says here, if you continue, this live video won't be saved unless you've previously chosen to archive all your live videos for 30 days. So I'm going to go discard and then I'm going to come over to my mobile phone. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to my hamburger menu, the top right, and you can see that we have this archive tab. I'm going to click the archive tab. And there's the video that I've just done. I've done a couple more, but I'm going to click that one. And as you can see, I have the video there. So what I can do is I can either share that to my Instagram account or I can download it. So when I'm downloading it, that's going to save directly to my camera roll on my phone. And I can also click the share option. Now, when I share it, it's going to show me you've saved live videos are now reels, so we know that, so we're going to click OK. So now what's happened is it saved my live video to my Instagram account, and I can change my cover if I want to. Once you're happy with your cover, you can write in the caption. Okay, then I'm going to tag StreamYard like so, and then I'm going to click done, and then I'm going to share that, and that's going to show on my grid where my reels would go. Okay, so there you can see that the live video is now on my profile. If I click my profile, you can see that it's in my reels area and it's also on the square grid. Now, if we go back to StreamYard, we can also go to our dashboard, return to dashboard, and we can see that our streams and recordings will be saved in the past area. And you can see that I have my Instagram live recorded inside of StreamYard. I've got a couple of other ones as well where I did a test, but you can view this and then it's there ready for you to download and put onto your computer, or you can click the edit and repurpose option inside of StreamYard, which we'll cover in another video. So I hope you found this video useful. It's a game changer for those of you who like to live stream from your desktop rather than your mobile phone, to be able to live stream from StreamYard into Instagram at the same time as perhaps you're live streaming to your YouTube channel, to your LinkedIn account, and to your Facebook account. So why don't you give it a go and let me know in the comments below this video how you got on. And if you've had any problems live streaming from StreamYard to your Instagram account, then feel free to ask a question below this video as well. My name's Anita Wong, and I'm here to help you gain visibility from using video on Facebook and Instagram. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.